What up, what up, what up? Welcome to the Second Childhood Podcast, the life of a man in Vegas. That man is me, Inky Man, doing it to your eardrums. Inky Man out to win in the city of San to the Ambiatch. What it do? Yo. So I did my very first podcast yesterday, man, and I'm not gonna lie to you, man. Just getting used to the equipment and the things that I could get away with made me a little Hank Shockley. You dig what I'm saying? Shock being the key word. But I'm feeling a little comfortable, and I'm so damn comfortable right now that I'm eating a bowl of Raisin Bran, ladies and gentlemen. Mm-hmm. A bowl of Raisin Bran. Mm-hmm. All up in your ears, man. I'm doing it all in your eardrums, you know what I'm saying, man? But that's just how this is going down, man. I'm comfortable right now. So, today's podcast is some news that I had gleaned. Big shout out to my man, EJ, Eric the Red. He put me onto an app called Smart News. And essentially, this gives you up-to-the-minute news updates on various things. And so, I took a couple of things out that I'm going to talk about in this podcast and give y'all my views on it, but I thought they were kind of weird. So the first one is about Carlos Carvalho. Hopefully I said that name right. Carlos Carvalho. Now, apparently he was a photographer. He was into the cinematography and things like that. Very well known in the industry. And he was doing a project. He was filming a project about a British family that was living in a gaming lodge, or a game lodge, sorry. And he went to take a shot of, picture of a giraffe. And the giraffe headbutted him, sent him 16 feet into the air, according to the report, and he died. Now, there's a few things that are weird about this. Not only because this man died from a headbutt from a giraffe, but the giraffe's name was Gerald. And the lodge refuses to put him down because he did nothing wrong. Now, I don't know. See, this kind of reminds me of the story of Coco. Was it Coco? I'm sorry. The gorilla that had that kid, dragging him around, and trying to figure out should he kill the gorilla because of the things he did with the kid, and so on and so forth. You know, Cat Williams said one time in his one of his comedy specials, he was saying that they're animals. These are animals. When you're in their vicinity, they do what animals do. You know what I mean? This man was trying to get a shot, being creative, doing what it is that he does. He tried to take a picture of this giraffe and the giraffe headbutt. Crazy. So move on to this, man. Let's move on. The next thing I found, apparently there was a guy known for masturbating on the subway. And the thing was, they were saying that he was terrorizing subway riders. The terrorizing part being that he picked his nose and he jerked off on the subway. Now, I don't know if that's terror. It's horrifying. I don't know if that's terror. Maybe it's terrifying to little kids because they didn't see something like that. Maybe it's educational because now a little boy can understand what he can do with this thing that he'd been wearing all this time. I don't know. But apparently, he's been terrorizing subway riders. The man's name was Dennis Patrick. He was finally caught. Apparently, he had two attacks. One was on the E train back in September. Another was on the A train at the 14th Street station. These two attacks. And he was apparently got away, and they finally busted him. Then the story went on to talk about a guy named Juan Funes, who's 31 years old, who is a Subway masturbator, caught January 26th at Chambers Street Station. Now, I mean, let me tell y'all something. This brother that y'all listening to right now, he's going through a little bit of a drought, but I really don't see the pleasure in pleasuring myself in front of a group of people. See, if you're at least gonna be tuned in to what I'm doing over here, somebody need to help a brother out. You mean somebody need to help a brother out? You know what I mean? I got a problem here. The community needs to be active. I don't know. That's just my dumb way of thinking about stuff. You know what I mean? I have one more thing that I need to go ahead and get into. One more topic, but let's get into this song that I'm about. The title of it is "Think Twice" by a group called I and I. I think it's rather fitting for the story that I have just told. Let's get into it right here.
The sucker MC to get dismantled. I hope that you can handle your witness or cease your flipping. Getting down with my lazy boy laid back style of speak. The funk makes you dance cheek to cheek. I be the black civilian who was bound to make a million or make enough dough so I could buy my own pavilion. Throw a fat party and invite everybody and play all the old school hits like Lottie Dottie. Connections like OPEC, why you hung up like a coat check? I'm real like a ruby, why you fake like a pinchbeck? That's imitation gold if you didn't know. My rhymes flow as my vocab grows and grows. I freak it for the bass lines, always walking on your front line. Catch me while I'm booming in your Alpine. Yo, I'm out like a shot from a tech. You need to think twice just to earn respect, so.
So sucker MCs, please think twice. They don't know what you're doing, think about that. So sucker MCs, please think twice. Don't know what you're doing, think about that. So sucker MCs, please think twice. They don't know what you're doing, think about that. So sucker MCs, please think twice. They don't know what you're doing, think about that.
Hey yo, as I come through for 95 with the flave so amazing, the boy wonder's blazing. Respect the mic check, 1, 2, cause I display the funk material as I stand imperial to others. Gotta lay low, undercover, cash flow through the hands for the crowd in the stands, so here I am. Plus I rock to please the public, they want it, words son, they want it. To hear the soul brother disperse words of wisdom, with I and I coming direct on the set. So represent, a lot of rap niggas came and went, with the style played out when they chose a different route. But whatever, as I stay true to the game, word to the trouble T-Roy, you know my name. Keep an eye on the snakes as I watch my back. Think twice before you try to grab the mic and react.
Sucker MC, please think twice. Don't know what you're doing, think about that.
Yo, Drew, what up, man? Yeah, let's go.
Everybody wanna rap, everybody wanna sing, everybody do their thing like a motherfucking robot. When the show start, what you know about? How to go about this? Everybody wanna rap, everybody wanna sing, everybody do their thing like a motherfucking robot. When the show start, what you know about? How to go about this?
Seems like you can't sing a rap these days without auto-tune in the back these days. Well, fuck that, I got something to say with brown blunts, green weed, and the smoke is gray. See, hey! The best to do it was Roger Troutman. Nah, shorty T-Pain didn't come out then. I was about 10, had striped Adidas. Raised from back in the days, all types of leaders. Now, I'm like, dang, they sound the same. But voice is original, he off the reins. Dr. J, Barry White, whoa. Barry Manilow, the flow like that, he nice. So, keep that original flow, that Bucktown, duck down. That shit you know. And I don't flip no O's. 2000 and right now when I spit they know.
Everybody wanna rap, everybody wanna sing, everybody do they thing like a motherfucking robot. When the show stop, what you know about, how to go about this.
Everybody wanna rap, everybody wanna sing, everybody do they thing like a motherfucking robot. When the show stop, what you know about,
how to go about this. Whoo! That second joint was by KRS-One and Buckshot of Duck Down, you know, Boot Camp, Click, Black Moon. You know, and now and then you're going to hear music from me. So far, you've heard music every time. Yeah, now and then you're going to hear music from me. If you're a person that's into 90s hip-hop, you're going to hear that. Trust. So anyway, I got one more topic that I need to discuss, and then you know, I'm limited on time here, so I'm going to go ahead and make this quick. One of the headlines was talking about wholesale weed prices. And I thought this was rather, it was great, it was rather interesting. So, back in September of 2015, June 2016, you can get weed wholesale at $2,100 per pound back then. Late September to the end of 2017, prices dropped to $1,500 a pound. Where they do that at? Anyway, not that I was a big, you know, not that I was ever a big drug dealer or anything. You know, anybody that smoked weed has at least sold it at least once. Even if it's something that you've had on your personal stash and you just gave somebody a quick $5, $10 piece. But this right here, the reason I'm touching on this is because there was a guy out there, my man Josh, who wanted me to talk about weed, mainly weed reviews, but the weed in general. The thing that gets me about this particular headline and why it's something that's standing out to me is because weed, now that it's legal in different areas, it's taking a turn. And now you're starting to see celebrities that you didn't know smoke. And you're starting to see shows that people are smoking in them. You know what I mean? So that's why I brought that up, man. Because, you know, it's amazing where weed has gotten right now. What weed is all about right now. You know what I mean? That it's so in your face now and it's so accepted now that I don't know. I just never thought I'd see this day, man. I never thought I'd see this day. Lastly, I was in a dispensary one time, and I was so surprised at how easy it was to get that stuff. Whereas I can recall doing it the dirty way, riding around in the streets of Bridgeport, going to different famous blocks to get weed, and they had to go behind the bushes and go through tennis balls and all this other stuff in order to serve you. I don't know. Maybe that's just a little bit too much information. You know what I'm saying? I thought I would go ahead and speak on that because I know a little bit of something on that, and why not? Because I ain't the only one. You know what I'm saying? So I'd like to thank y'all for tuning in, man. Let me do it to y'all in y'all eardrums for this 15 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Second podcast. Love y'all for supporting Second Childhood, my second childhood. This is how this is going down. Let's go ahead and get on out of here. I see y'all.
This concludes the broadcast from World Control.
Let's pretend like this never happened.
Look, I don't like having to trust anyone because I'm always disappointed. But just once, I'd like to know that I could actually trust someone. That for at least one person, everything wasn't about money or power.
Cut the crap, Ola, sister. It won't wash here.